welcome to a look back at Union Pacific Excursion Engines. This was definitely one of, if not the most, suggested video from you guys in recent weeks and months, so here it is. If you guys have any suggestions for future videos, feel free to leave those in the comments section below. And now, without further ado, let's get started. Our first engine is Union Pacific number 618. 618 is a 280 consolidation built by the Baldwin Locomotive Works in July of 1907. The locomotive was originally built for and delivered to the Oregon Short Line Railroad, a subsidiary of Union Pacific, as locomotive number 1068. In its early years of revenue service, the locomotive was mostly assigned to freight duties, hauling trains out of Idaho and Utah. Around 1915, the 1068, along with its sister engines, were renumbered based on Union Pacific designation, and as such, the 1068 became the 618. And for the next couple of decades following this, things would remain very much the same for the locomotive. This all changed during World War II when the locomotive was reassigned to Ogden, Utah. During its time in Ogden, the 618 would frequently make runs delivering supplies between Ogden Yard and the nearby Military Defense Depot. Following the end of the war, the 618 would continue to see use on various short lines and branch lines owned by the Union Pacific system, until the locomotive was eventually retired in 1955. Following 3 years in storage, the 618 was then donated to the state of Utah and moved to Salt Lake City, where it was placed on display in the Utah State Fairgrounds. The 618 would remain on display in the fairgrounds for 12 years, until 1970, when the fairgrounds needed to expand, and the 618 was on prized land. Fortunately, the Promontory chapter of the National Railway Historical Society was able to step in and save the locomotive after convincing the state to donate the locomotive to them. Following the acquisition of the 618 by the Historical Society, the locomotive was moved to Provo, Utah in December of that year for a special run up Provo Canyon. From there, the locomotive made the run from Provo to Heber City, Utah, where the locomotive began operation on the nearby Heber Valley Railroad, and its well-known Heber Creeper passenger train. Arguably the biggest claim to fame for the 618 occurred in the winter of 2002, when it and running mate number 75 were tasked with double-heading the special Olympic torch train for the Winter Olympics occurring in Salt Lake City nearby. Between 1970 and now, the 618 has gone in and out of service for a number of overhauls over the years. Its most recent overhaul began at the end of the 2010 operating season, and is currently expected to be completed sometime in 2021. Moving from a more mid-sized engine to one of the larger locomotives that Union Pacific employed on their roster, our next locomotive is Challenger number 3967. Number 3967 is a 4664 Challenger built by the American Locomotive Company in 1943 to assist with the war effort. In terms of overall purpose, the Union Pacific Challengers are very similar to the Nickel Plate Road Berkshires operating in the Midwest, in that they were both designed to haul a lot of tonnage at track speed. It was not at all uncommon to see a Challenger hauling along at 60 or even 70 miles an hour with a loaded freight train. The Challengers are also very comfortable handling high-speed passenger trains as well. Back to the 3967 though, the locomotive's time and revenue service was not all unlike the other Challengers on the UP system. In 1953 though, the locomotive was elected to run a special excursion sponsored by the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club. On May 13th of that year, the locomotive would make a special round-trip excursion between Denver, Colorado and Cheyenne, Wyoming, with many photo run-by opportunities along the way for the fans on board. While this may sound like your average fan trip excursion for this time period, it was significant in that this was the first special excursion train ever operated by the Union Pacific, the first of many to come. Unfortunately, the 3967 would not live to see these future excursions, as the locomotive was retired at the end of 1957 and ultimately scrapped in 1960. Fortunately, the 3967 would see a temporary revival in 1993, when sister engine 3985 masqueraded as her to celebrate the 40th anniversary of the excursion. Speaking of the 3985, that would in fact be our next engine. Like sister 3967, 3985 was built by the American Locomotive Company in 1943 for use on fast and heavy freight trains in the mountains of Wyoming and Utah. After 14 years of service on the Union Pacific, the 3985 would make its last revenue run in 1957. The Challenger was then placed in storage in the Cheyenne Roundhouse and officially retired in 1962. After another 13 years in storage, the Union Pacific eventually decided to place the locomotive on display outside the historic Cheyenne Depot in 1975. The locomotive wouldn't remain on display for very long though, for in 1979, a volunteer group made up of Union Pacific employees began work on restoring the locomotive to operational condition. The restoration would be completed in 1981, and the 3985 would go on to make its first major excursion appearance later that same year, when it attended Railfare 81 in Sacramento, California. From then on, the 3985 would go on to pull a number of excursions for Union Pacific across the western half of the United States. After being fed up with having to deal with the constant line-side fires caused by the 3985, the Union Pacific made the decision to convert the locomotive from burning coal to oil in 1990. Not only did this decision solve the fire problem, but it also greatly increased 3985's range and availability as an excursion engine. This newfound range would be put to the test in the fall of 1992, when the 3985 ventured deep into CSX territory to pull the 50th running of the Clinchfield Santa train in the states of Kentucky and Virginia. For this occasion, the 3985 was relettered and renumbered to Clinchfield Railroad No. 676, as it bore a strong resemblance to the Challengers that the Clinchfield used to use during the steam era. This wouldn't be the last time the 3985 underwent another identity. As previously mentioned, the locomotive was dressed up as 3967 to commemorate the 50th anniversary of the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club special, and on the return trip from that excursion, locomotive engineer Steve Lee decided to renumber the engine once again to 3718, for seemingly no other reason than to mess with people. Following this excursion, the 3985 would continue to see use in excursion service, appearing at multiple rail fairs and NRHS conventions throughout the 1990s and early 2000s. The locomotive would make its final runs in the fall of 2010 when it ran a series of trips between Cheyenne, Wyoming and Denver, Colorado, and as part of those trips, the locomotive even headed up the Barnum & Bailey Circus train. The locomotive was initially set to be pulled from service so it could have its FRA-mandated 15-year overhaul. However, as the years went on, the Union Pacific Steam Team's priority began to shift to Big Boy No. 4014, which we'll get to later. Because of this, the Union Pacific would officially retire 3985 from their excursion program in January of 2020, and today the locomotive continues to sit in the Union Pacific Steam Shops in Cheyenne, Wyoming. Our next engine is locomotive No. 4466. 4466 is an 060 switch engine built by the Lima Locomotive Works in October of 1920. The locomotive would spend the vast majority of its career in revenue service serving the yard and shop complex in Cheyenne, Wyoming. It was mainly tasked with towing either dead or partially steamed up steam locomotives between the shop complex, roundhouse, and the ready tracks. After steam was phased out in and around Cheyenne, Wyoming, the 4466 was moved to Grand Island, Nebraska for yet more switching duties in 1960, and the locomotive was later retired from service in 1962. Following its retirement, the locomotive would be stored in Grand Island, Nebraska for the better part of a decade before being donated to the Railway and Locomotive Historical Society in 1973. They would then hold on to the locomotive for another 5 years before donating it to the California State Railroad Museum in 1978. Following a decision to restore the locomotive to operational condition, the locomotive steamed again in 1984 and began pulling passenger trains for the museum throughout Old Sacramento, even interchanging passengers with the nearby steamboat tours. One of its more notable moments in excursion service occurred in 1986 when the locomotive ventured north of the border to Vancouver, British Columbia to participate in Steam Expo. While at the event, the 4466, along with the tens of other locomotives in attendance, partook in the grand parade of steam locomotives to open up the event, before remaining on display until its conclusion. If you'd like to learn more about some of the other locomotives that were in attendance for this event, I encourage you to check out some of the other videos in this series. Following the conclusion of Steam Expo, the 4466 returned to Sacramento and continued out its normal operation duties. That is, until 1999, when the state of California banned the use of coal-fired steam locomotives. With the museum not having enough funding to convert the 4466 to oil, they decided to retire the locomotive from service. Today, the locomotive can still be found on static display in the California State Railroad Museum. And now we've come to two of arguably the most popular locomotives, not just on the UP system, but in the entirety of the United States. Union Pacific number 844 and 4014. Each locomotive is equally as unique and impressive in their own right, with 844 having the distinction of being the only mainline steam locomotive to never be retired from active service, and 4014 serving as the largest operating steam locomotive in the world. To start this segment off, let's begin with 844's story first. The 844 story begins in the late 1930s. Union Pacific's fleet of 482 locomotives were beginning to struggle to meet the increasing demands for both freight and passenger traffic. The Union Pacific decided to turn to Alco for help in alleviating these problems. The Union Pacific wanted a locomotive that could pull heavy passenger trains of up to 20 cars long at up to 90 miles an hour on flat grounds. After going back and forth with Alco on a number of different design options, the Union Pacific eventually placed an order for 20 484 FEF-class locomotives in 1937. The Northerns were so successful that in 1939, Union Pacific placed another order for 15 FEF-2-class locomotives, and again in 1944 with a batch of 10 FEF-3s. 844 would be the last of these FEF-3s built. The 844 was delivered to the Union Pacific in December of 1944, and was immediately pressed into service to help meet the wartime traffic demands. As the UP had already discovered with the rest of the fleet, the 844 found herself right at home on both fast freight and crack passenger trains. When the 844 wasn't hauling strings of boxcars across the plains in Nebraska, it was heading up famous passenger trains such as the Overland Limited, Portland Rose, and the Challenger. In 1946, the 844, along with the rest of her sisters, were converted from burning coal to No. 5 fuel oil, the fuel which it still burns to this day. As the late 1950s rolled around, so did the end of steam on the Union Pacific system. By 1959, 844 found herself in storage in Cheyenne, Wyoming. Instead of retiring and scrapping the locomotive like many of its sisters before it, the Union Pacific instead elected to keep 844 around on their active roster and began using it for fan trip excursions throughout the 1960s. In 1962, the locomotive would be renumbered to 8444, as one of the Union Pacific's diesels at the time carried the road number 844. It would carry this road number until the early 1990s. One of the more notable trips to come from the 844 in the 1960s occurred in 1969, when the locomotive took over the Golden Spike Centennial Limited from Nickel Plate 759 at Salt Lake City, Utah, and then took the train to Ogden, Utah to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the driving of the Golden Spike. It would later hand the train back to the 759, where it would finish out its tour. One excursion special that the 844 would frequently find itself heading up was the Denver Post Cheyenne Frontier Day Special, which was a round trip from Denver, Colorado to Cheyenne, Wyoming and back. Unfortunately, the annual excursion special was discontinued after 2018. As the 1970s rolled into the 1980s, the 844 began seeing use in more marquee railroad events around the country. In 1984, the 844, along with Southern Pacific Daylight No. 4449, would both be displayed at the New Orleans World's Fair. 5 years later, the two locomotives would see each other teaming up again in 1989 to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Los Angeles Union Passenger Terminal. They would kick off the event by doing a side-by-side photo run into the station, and they would end off the event a few days later by having a race through Cajon Pass by making use of Southern Pacific and Santa Fe's parallel main lines through the mountains, which Union Pacific had trackage rights over. It was also around this time that Union Pacific elected to paint 844 into the iconic Greyhound paint scheme. However, after a few years, this was done away with due to the crews having difficulty in keeping it clean. Throughout the 1980s and 1990s, the 844 and the aforementioned 3985 would often team up and head to Sacramento for the various California State Railroad Museum rail fairs that they would host, as well as a whole slew of NRHS conventions in between. Between 1999 and 2004, the 844 would be taken out of service after a major flue failure that would occur at California Rail Fair in 99. After returning to operation in 2004, the 844 would go on to team up with Daylight 4449 yet again for a series of doubleheader excursions in the Pacific Northwest in 2007. In 2013, it was discovered that the brackets holding 844's iconic Mars light in place had deteriorated beyond repair, and as such, the Mars light was removed. Shortly following this, the 844 was once again pulled from service for boiler work. While this work was underway, the Union Pacific elected that it was the best time to conduct its 15-year rebuild, so that's exactly what they did, and in 2016, the 844 once again returned to operation. Although the locomotive hasn't operated since 2019, the 844 is still an active member of UP's steam program and an active locomotive on the UP roster overall, and will continue to see use by Union Pacific and Excursion Service for years to come. And with that, that brings us to the King of the Rails himself, Union Pacific Big Boy No. 4014. The Union Pacific Big Boys were born out of necessity to meet wartime traffic demands, and as such, the Big Boys began rolling out in 1941. Big Boy 4014 was built by the American Locomotive Company in November of 1941 in Schenectady, New York. Once the Big Boys were completed, they were among the largest steam locomotives ever constructed. They were also among the most powerful, having the capability to pull trains of up to 5.5 miles long. In all, 25 Big Boys were built between 1941 and 1944. In revenue service, most big boys could be found slugging it out on the steep grades of Sherman Hill, which ran between Cheyenne and Laramie, Wyoming, or Wasatch Grade, which runs between Ogden and Evanston, Utah. Unfortunately, the big boys' reign would be cut short due to the rise of the diesel. After a 13-year-long career on Union Pacific, number 4014 was retired in 1959. In 1961, Union Pacific elected to donate the 4014 to the Southern California chapter of the Railway and Locomotive Historical Society. The society would then place the 4014 on display at the Rail Giants Train Museum located within the LA County Fairplex in Pomona, California. The 4014 was one of 8 big boys to be saved from the cutter's torch at this time. The 4014 would spend the next 52 years on display at the Rail Giants Train Museum, but that would all change in 2013 when Union Pacific announced its intent to reacquire and restore Big Boy 4014 to operation to help celebrate the 150th anniversary of the driving of the Golden Spike. Later that same year, the 4014's journey to restoration began when it was towed across the Fairplex parking lot onto active rails once again. Later in the spring of 2014, a special consist was put together and the 4014 was towed from Los Angeles to Cheyenne over a multi-day period. After the then ongoing work on the 844 was completed, work quickly began on the 4014 to return it to operation. The restoration work would be completed in late April of 2019, and for the first time in 60 years, the 4014 steamed again. Following a quick series of test runs, the 4014 would set out on its inaugural excursion, which was a doubleheader with 844 from Cheyenne to Ogden, Utah. There, a special 150th anniversary celebration would be held, with the two locomotives being the main centerpiece. Following this first excursion, the 4014 would then set out on a number of tours across the Union Pacific system, heading as far west as Los Angeles, California, and as far east as Chicago. Further plans for a tour to New Orleans were canceled due to the coronavirus in 2020. However, in 2021, those tours would resume again, and at the time of narrating this, the 4014 is on her way to New Orleans, Louisiana. And with that, that wraps up a look back at Union Pacific excursion engines. If you have any suggestions for future videos in this series or any constructive criticisms, please leave them in the comments section below. I'd like to thank you all for your continued support of this series. I'd also like to thank you all for your continued support of the channel overall, as we recently passed 800 subscribers. Thank you so much, it really means a lot. Anyway, that's gonna do it for this video. Thanks for watching.